You've seen us unbox the Honeycomb Bravo throttle, but now see it in action with a selection of GA aircraft in Microsoft Flight Simulator.
Aligned with the runway and climb to 5,400 feet. We're going for a left-hand traffic pattern.
Thank you.
Once we reach altitude, you're gonna start turning left 90 degrees toward a 122 degree heading. Okay, we're in the pattern. Get ready to enter the crosswind section. Good. Keep going till you reach the traffic pattern altitude of 5,700 feet. Ready to make your left turn downwind? When the runway appears at the halfway point of your wing strut, you'll know you're at a good glide distance. Track. Lower your nose to a cruise attitude and reduce power to 2100 RPMs. Once your speed is in the white arc, add 10 degrees of flaps to prep us for landing. Now's not a bad time to check if the runway is looking good. And, it probably goes without saying, always watch out for other planes entering or exiting the pattern. Fly past the end of the runway here. Keep going till you see it at a 45 degree angle behind you. That's your cue to turn left again onto the base leg. Altitude and maintain cruise attitude. Keep an eye on the runway as we get ready for our final turn. That'll also keep our speed around 65 knots. There we go. The runway's in full view. Make sure to keep the plane centered on approach. If you're too high, add flaps. Too low, add power to maintain the glide path. Just apply the brakes to slow your roll. And make sure you don't stop on the runway, of course. If other planes are looking to land, we've got to move. Take one of the taxiways on the right. Good job. As an old instructor said to me, not only did you not die, you're really learning to fly.